guess who's slowing down as he goes by?
That's right. Oh, look at this. What's this cocksucker gonna say? Here he comes. I knew it was going to continue. Can I help you?
Yeah, hi. Hey, we've gotten a complaint.
Another fake complaint?
Okay. So you're not parked here between 10 p.m. and 5 a.m., is that correct?
I can tell you exactly who's doing that. It's that guy that just pulled out. He's in another RV.
Okay.
And he's a strange dude. He's a very strange dude. Now, it's not 10 p.m., and it's not 5 a.m.
Oh, right here, it says no parking, 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. around that time?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. No,
so what about it?
No, that's why I'm just asking, because you said that RVs have been parked here for like 2 months, and I'm assuming the complaint is because they've been parked here for 24 hours.
An anonymous complaint?
No, I've got a name and a phone number.
Really? Can I have it?
No, I can't.
Well, of course not. Well,
I'm just asking.
You come by 10 p.m. to 5 a.m., you won't see anybody here.
No, we will.
Yeah, you guys, you know, you're up and down.
I'm not trying to be a jerk.
I understand, neither am I.
No, I know, yeah.
I know it's a false complaint because I know. Well, I've heard the guy. Somebody told me about him. He's a guy that just pulled out in that RV that parks in front of the motel.
He didn't answer my phone call, so I can tell you that much.
The guy is weird. He's a creepy guy. Okay. And he's been doing this to everybody.
No, I see that you have these signs, but obviously.
I know what's up. So. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you know what? When we get a call, we just have to check.
You know, I've got all the codes and everything printed on the side right there. So, you know, anybody that doesn't understand that. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I'm not meaning to harass you or anything like that. I just wanted, since you're in here, I tried to talk to the person up there, and there's nobody up there either. So I just wanted to talk to see what's going on. Because
you're welcome to come by at 10 to 5. Well, I think there's a bit more. 10 to 5, there's nobody here. Somebody seems to have a problem with RVs, which is very strange, because this is supposed to be like the epitome of freedom in America, you know, an RV, you know.
All right, sir.
Especially a businessman like myself, I'm just trying to get by like everybody else.
Okay. Well, very good.
So I find it interesting that as he pulled out, you guys pulled out almost immediately and pulled up.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He's in that beater RV.
Within 5 minutes. I'm going to be leaving here in about five minutes.
He's a creepy guy. He's in that beater RV that parks over on the other side in front of the motel all the time. Okay. And I've been told by someone else that he's filing false complaints all the time. I don't know. He's a weird guy.
Well,
it's like he.
I'm gonna get back to my dispatch and say, you know, we came out here. There are a few RVs legally parked because it's between, you know, it's not between 10 and 10.
If he keeps doing it, you got his name and number. I would suggest filing a complaint against him because he's false complaints to the police is an illegal thing, right? Okay.
Well, and what we'll say is, you know, send somebody out here after 10 p.m.
Oh yeah, 10 to yeah.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
You're welcome.
All right,
bye. Getting another score. They're getting. That was interesting. That was very interesting. I was watching. There's this creepy guy in an RV. This old beater, loud RV. The guy's got like no muffler. Apparently he's been down here for quite a while. He parks in front of the Topanga Motel over there. And he's a weird guy. Apparently he was hitting on some of the wives and daughters of some of the families that have parked here in the past, creeping them out. And when they rebuffed him, he got pissed and started making these false calls to the sheriff's department. And I just found it very interesting. As the moment he pulled out going toward L.A., down that way, a sheriff's deputy pulls out from in front of this other RV down there, all the way down by the light, makes a U-turn, comes all the way down here, turns right on top of me. This shit is just unbelievable. They won't give it up. Parks right behind me. Like, you know, were they directed toward me? And then they say, were you here from 10 to 5 in the morning? It's 4:30 in the afternoon. You want to know if I'm here from 10 to 5? They know perfectly well I fucking wasn't here from 10 to 5 because they have patrols all night long that the people in Malibu are paying extra for. In Malibu. The sheriff's deputies have got it into their heads that they're going to make sure this area is kept clear for all of these goofy surfers and this other goofy guy in this RV who seems to think this is his private domain. I mean, there are some creepy fucking people around. I mean, creepy. But I've met a couple of nice ones. Unfortunately, these sheriff's deputies have managed to harass and chase off the nice, you know, young couple. Guy's got dreads. He's got three little babies in his, you know, little toddlers in his RV. And they were rousting them, these Soviets. These Soviet thugs were rousting them at 2:33 in the morning, scaring the shit out of these poor little babies. And that guy has left. He's gone. I don't know where he went. There's another family that, you know, he's looking for work. The guy's intelligent. I've been talking to him. His name's Vince Neal. Vince Neal, of all things. But he's a really super nice guy, intelligent, and he's been videotaping these cops and telling them what they're doing is not a nice thing, besides being illegal. You know, it's intimidation, and she looked at the signs that I've got up here that say, you know, don't ask me for ID. I'm not driving. Saying, don't violate my rights. It's right there in the California and U.S. Constitution. And also in the California Civil Code, 52.1 or something. And the U.S. Code, which is, it's on the side of the coach. So they've read my stuff. And I said, it's right there. You know, so are the other codes. You know, it's just so interesting that I've been sitting in here with the blinds drawn. I was reading and I was working on the computer. And as soon as I opened the blinds and sat down in the front to take a look out the front here, this cocksucker across the road, this creepy guy in this beat-up RV, it's one of these Class Cs, a piece of shit, loud, he pulls out, obviously gives some kind of signal to the cops that the guy's in his RV, he's, you know, I just saw him. He goes down off the road. They turn around and boom, like a flash, they're right behind me. Oh, I mean, were you here between 10 and 4 or 10 and 5 a.m., 10 p.m.? Fuck off! You want to know? I said, come back at 10. This thing's going to get too long. I won't be able to email it or upload it. But this shit's getting interesting. This is a fun saga. And I wrote a letter to all the major newspapers and even the local papers, saying, you know, I'm being rousted and harassed, you know, for wanting to live without paying some Zionist rent. Apparently that's not allowed in L.A. anymore. The beaches are no longer public. They're for the public, but not for people. I even saw a letter. I'm going to have to read the letter over the thing. A letter in the Malibu Times from some jackass, I don't know if it was tongue-in-cheek or if they were serious and they got a problem. They were saying, oh, these poor people are encroaching on Malibu, and now they're talking about low-income housing. Low-income housing, you know, if you're making less than 50 grand a year, it's low-income. You know, not people that are destitute, like, you know, millions of Americans. And it said, and they're encroaching on our beaches. Wait a minute, the beaches are public. The people of California own every inch of sand on the beaches. You know, from the high tide, which is clear up to these houses in Malibu. The tide comes clear up underneath their houses. So all of that belongs to the people. And you can walk and sit and do whatever you want on any of these beaches, including the one at Broad Beach, which is known as Billionaire Beach. I've been to it. I've seen it. I've, you know, and these guys, these billionaires, just bulldozed it 20 years ago up into their backyards, destroyed this beautiful, pristine, wide, broad beach. And then it turns out, oh, well, gosh, I guess that upset the balance of nature because now the ocean is coming up and threatening their property. It just comes up and just starts washing out all of these embankments that they built. So they start putting all these gigantic pieces of plastic bags. I mean, these things are as big as trucks. They stuck in trying to stop the ocean from doing what it does. And it just, they're not being cited for all of this plastic and shit that's being washed out night after night into the ocean. Now, these billionaires are now saying that the beach needs to be rebuilt. And they're going, oh, it's going to be private funds. Yeah, private funds, just like the $28 trillion bailout for these billionaire, no, they're not even billionaires, they're not trillionaires. These people, their wealth cannot be measured. These motherfuckers have taken $28 trillion from the American people, and the American people don't even know what happened. And they're Zionists. I'm not going to, you know. And it's not, don't say Jew. Jews, the Jews are being used. They've been used by these Zionists for almost 300 years. As a scapegoat. So, you know, fuck that shit. And now I got these cocksucking cops up my ass, you know. Just keep it up, you know. Keep it up. One of these days, they're going to push it. You know, they're going to try to... I was told myself, before I sign off here, I'm going to put a picture of Gandhi on the vehicle. And the quotation is going to be, passive resistance plus the Second Amendment. I don't own any guns. I'll tell you, put it here right now. Because they can actually tap into your phones now as they drive by or park near you. They can steal the information from your phones and your laptops without them even being on because the back door's been put in. Oh, look who's coming back. Look who's coming back. His timing is impeccable. That's the guy right there. That's the motherfucker in the green RV. She says she knows who the guy was. Now, apparently he has a buddy on the force, is what I've heard. He knows somebody somewhere, and why they tolerate him, some creepy guy, and nobody else, God knows. He's probably got some dirt on one of the deputies out here. But apparently this is the guy. I'm really tempted to confront him, but I don't think I will. This is getting long-winded, because I want to stop and look at it and put it on the computer and then get it online somewhere. I want to start uploading these things to my website so they're stored somewhere. Because if I turn up dead one day at the hands of these cocksuckers, everybody's going to know that it was passive resistance and not the Second Amendment that caused it. Welcome to the United States of... The Soviet states of America, they're no longer, we're no longer a republic. I don't think we ever were.